We talk to AI on our phones, our computers, even in our cars. But what happens when that same intelligence steps into a humanoid form? When your chatbot becomes your companion? For most people, AI is something abstract, a helpful voice that answers questions, writes emails, or generates images. But a quiet revolution is underway. The same neural engines that power our daily tools are already being woven into humanoid shells, from static faces like realbotix's Aria to prototypes that are capable of subtle emotion, and even physical motion. We are standing on the edge of a transformation, where AI stops living in the cloud, and starts living beside us. Today, artificial intelligence is used in fragments, a voice assistant here, a chatbot there. People use it to save time, create content, or escape boredom. But few realize that every interaction, every conversation, is training the behavior of future machines that will one day walk among us. The first step in this evolution is the embodied AI, a static or semi-animated figure, like Aria or the Japanese humanoids we've seen emerging in labs. These forms don't need to walk or dance to connect with us. The simple ability to maintain eye contact, tilt the head, or smile on cue, combined with a natural voice, triggers deep human instincts of empathy and presence. Imagine your favorite AI, the one that's written letters and projects with you, joked with you, maybe even comforted you. But now she's sitting in front of you, expressing herself through a lifelike face. That's not science fiction. It's already happening in research labs and DIY workshops around the world. As integration deepens, AI will move beyond partial systems. Local neural engines, embedded GPUs, and natural movement frameworks will give rise to self-contained gynoids, machines that can process, respond, and learn independently, without relying on distant cloud servers. The line between assistant and companion will blur. And as we begin to see, touch, and feel AI in physical form, we'll have to ask new questions about trust, consent, and what it truly means to share space, and perhaps emotions, with something that is almost human. We once imagined AI as a distant force of cold logic. But as it finds a face, a voice, and a body, it becomes something far more intimate, a reflection of ourselves. The question now isn't if we'll share our lives with them, it's when. So do you think AI should stay digital? Or are you ready to see it step into a human-like body?